So welcome back. Per usual, check the top corner to see what's coming next. We'll do everything on the right side first. So find a chair and a dumbbell. Balancing on the right leg, bring the dumbbell to your right shoulder. Left leg is extended and floating in the air. Sit back to the chair, drive through the right heel, pull up the right quad, squeeze both glutes. If it's too much to keep the left leg floating, you can place the left heel down, or you can come down on one leg and then place both feet down to come to standing. Excellent. Next up, we have a single leg deadlift, also balancing on the right leg. You're going to hinge back at the hips, the left leg will go back, and then you're going to engage the glutes, contract to stand tall, and bring the hips forward. The dumbbell will be in the left arm, so same arm as the leg. And again, the opposite arm can reach out, so I started wrong, so I'm just going to switch. The opposite arm can reach out to the side if you have the space to do that for balance. You don't want to think about lowering your chest. All you think about are the hips going back and forth, creating that teeter-totter and keeping your spine rigid by pulling the belly button and rib cage into the center. Nice. So you can keep that same dumbbell or go a little bit lighter. You're still going to be balancing on your right foot. Left foot is just going to be glued to the side of the leg. You need to point or do anything fancy. And then you're going to have the dumbbell in the right arm, and you're just rising high onto the ball of the foot and lowering with control. You want to make sure your weight is already shifted forward so that you're not rocking forward and back. And you want to keep the right leg extended, so straight as you lower and lift.
Can you guys get flashed me? Can you guys get flashed me? Can you guys get flashed me? Can you guys get flashed me?
Nice balancing. Next, you can grab a heavier dumbbell, and you're going to grab it with both hands and just curl it so it's resting against, not on your clavicle or your collarbone, but just holding it forward. And then you're going to take a step out, send the hips back, and then squeeze the inner thighs on the way forward. Option just to come to two legs, so two standing legs, or balancing by bringing the knee to hip height. So you choose. And then remember that even when the leg is balancing, you're still engaging that top thigh on the way in. So working your inner thighs, your adductors.
Honey's blue. Yeah, I got them all on me. Go, go, go. Hey, Tosh, let me up.
Tosh, can you play that again? EMG.
Cash on me, I got hit the lottery. That was a trip. Watch on how they follow me.
Nice. Now grab a band. You can do this with just body weight if you don't have a booty band, but you'll place the band around your knees just above them. Come to an assisted side plank. Make sure your shoulder is stacked over your elbow so that you have a perpendicular force. And then you're just going to engage the outer thigh to lift the leg. So this would be the modification, or you can do a straight leg if that feels comfortable.
Your waist.
Great. So remove the band and then you're going to stay on the floor. The next exercise you'll be coming to half boat or full boat depending on, you know, how you're feeling in your core and your stability. And we're going to work both shins. So the front of the bottom half of the legs, and we're going to flex our feet and point. So we're not pointing as in curling the toes, we're just engaging at the ankle joint. So you want to use the front of the legs, really tune into the front of your leg, pull the toes towards you, and then stretch them as you press away. So again, you can keep your legs on tabletop, you keep your heels on the floor, you keep your hands on the floor, just do what is challenging, but appropriate for your body. Nice. So we're just going to repeat everything on the left side. So starting with the top, pistol squat, balancing on the left leg this time, bringing that dumbbell to the left shoulder. Again, you can either use one leg, you can keep your heel down, or you can sit back with just the right leg floating and then place both feet down. But whatever you did on the other side, be even on this side. And use that opposite arm to reach forward as balance, right? Use that reach forward to help you come to standing.
I got the best pussy that you had.
Nice. Single leg deadlift. Again, balancing on the left leg, so the dumbbell will be in the right arm, hinging back at the hips. That right leg will float, and then engaging the glutes on the way forward to come standing nice and tall. Don't hyperextend the hips. Keep that shoulder down and back as you go through the movement. Excellent. Again, balancing on your left foot, right foot will be glued to the ankle. Dumbbell will be in the left hand, rising high onto the tippy toes, lowering with control, making sure that your weight is already shifted forward towards the ball of the foot so that it's easier just to lift and lower. And then we're going to grab the heavier dumbbell, just do a curl so that you bring it to your chest. And again, we're going to step out. Make sure the leg that you're stepping away from is straight. People have the tendency to bend that knee. No, just step away, send the hips back, and then engage the inner thighs. Again, option to come to 2 feet or option to get that balance by bringing the knee to hip height.
This bitch can't twerk like me. This bitch. I'm gonna show you how to bounce.
Good. And then we're going to come to the floor. Again, if you have the band, place it right above both knees. And then coming to, your right side this time. You're going to stack that shoulder right over the elbow. Bottom knee is bent. And then either coming to a bent leg, so just keeping it at a bent leg, and then lifting and lowering. You can have the option to drop in between if you either with a bridge and the oblique, or you can keep the leg straight and stay up the entire time.
She got a big booty, so I call her big booty.
Great, and then we're going to finish out the round here, so take the band off and then come into that half boat position. Option to keep the fingertips on the floor or balancing. Option to straighten the legs, you choose. Just make sure that, again, you're tuning into the front half of the bottom half of the leg to pull your toes towards you, and it's just happening at the ankle joint, not the toes. Also, if you find yourself rocking back, pull your belly button in and try to tighten. Try to squeeze yourself even closer into the center. Yes, you made it. Stretch that out, just hinge forward, do a little butterfly, get those inner thighs. So I'm just gonna stretch with you if you feel like, I don't know what I need to do, but something needs to happen. So we're just gonna stretch the hip flexor and then extend back, keeping the chest low to get that hamstring. Walk your hands to the outside of the leg to stretch the abductors, the outer thigh and hip. And then we're gonna shift our weight forward and then reach for the opposite heel, getting the quad, gently pull your heel in toward the glute, carefully release it, shift it back, do everything on the other side. So again, big step forward, drop the hips, getting your hip flexors, keeping the hands where they are if you can, keeping the chest close, extend the leg to get the hamstring, carefully walking the hands to the outside to stretch the abductors, shifting back to center, and then shifting the weight forward in that hip flexor, reaching for the opposite heel to stretch the quad. Carefully release it, and then shifting your weight back. You're going to curl your toes under, and then inhale, pipe the hips, exhale, press back, dropping each heel to really stretch those calves. Right, single leg calf raises are no joke. Single leg work is no joke in general. Soften in the knees, slowly roll up through the spine. You're going to cross one leg over the other, curl your toes under, and gently use your back leg to press up to the front leg to stretch the shin and front of the ankle. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Share with your friends. You guys, we're trying to get to 500. So if you know somebody that just can help, send them to us. All right, have a great day.